Last season's one-day champions, Nottinghamshire, began the new Royal London One-Day Cup competition with a 29-run win over Sussex in Horsham, thanks in part to 100 from Alex Hales. Ed Joyce inserted after winning the toss on what appeared to be a very good batting wicket with a fast outfield at this picturesque outground. Both Hales and Michael Lumb were soon finding the boundary with some excellent cricket shots. Not that Lumb always needed to use the turf, as he struck the first six in the 13th over after he and Hales had taken 50 runs off the opening 10 overs of power play. Lumb was the first to his 50 to give his side an ideal start as they tried to take the same road to Lords as last year. The powerful left-hander needed 58 balls for his half-century, from which he'd struck 5 fours and a 6. Six overs later, and Hales, a man desperate to represent England in the 50-over format, did his chances no harm at all by completing his own half-century off 73 balls. He'd batted within himself, hitting only 4 fours thus far. These two eventually took their partnership to 139 in 28 overs before Lumb on 77 ran down the pitch to Will Beer and was bowled. Hales showed how to take on the leg spinner, twice smashing him over mid-wicket for sixes. Nottinghamshire looked as if they were going to construct a massive total as they got to 180 for one with 17 overs of their innings still left. Sussex must have been fearing the worst. But they then began to fight back. On 13, James Taylor was foxed by a quicker, straighter delivery from Beer and was bowled. Samit Patel had made only 8 when he clipped Stefan Pilot out to Matt Machen, as Nottinghamshire kept their foot on the gas. But Ricky Vessels then ran himself out in spite of the dive as Beer hit the stumps from cover to remove the dangerous batsman for a 2-ball duck. That left the visitors on 207 for 4 in the 39th over, but Hales was still there and he went to his excellent 100 off 107 balls, from which he'd found the boundary on 8 occasions and cleared it twice. His reaction tells you how much it meant to him. He would love to be off to the World Cup in the winter. He'll have every chance of being on the plane after he moved to 116 with a third 6. This competition is giving a number of players a chance to shine ahead of the World Cup Down Under. Hales was out in the 42nd over with a total on 234 when he thrashed Pilot to Lewis Hatchett at long on. Pilot was excellent, his 10 overs bringing him figures of 2 for 35. Nottinghamshire were in danger of failing to make the most of their start when James Franklin lobbed a return catch to Beer, and Sussex would have been hopeful of keeping their opponents down to a score beneath 300. The fact that Notts got beyond that belonged a lot to Steven Mullaney, a more than useful one-day cricketer who doesn't get the accolades his play often deserves. From the 20 balls he faced, he hit 3 sixes, 2 in the end, just take this game away from Sussex. He gave the ball a real thwack. A more cultured shot actually brought about his downfall as he guided this delivery from Hatchett to Craig Kachopa to go for a rapid 40. The 300 was reached in the penultimate over, and then Ajmal Shahzad slogged Hatchett to Chris Nash after making 9. But Jake Ball came in and used a helicopter shot to clear the rope as Nottinghamshire ended on a very challenging 312 for 8, 63 runs coming off the final 5 overs. Chasing that kind of target down meant that Sussex needed a bright start, and they got one through Joyce and Luke Wells, who took 65 runs off the first 14 overs of their reply. Wells was out for 23, cutting Franklin to Taylor at point. Kachopa then struck his first legal delivery in List A cricket for a maximum, some start for the youngster who's played most of his cricket in New Zealand. Sussex's problem, though, was that they kept losing wickets, which set them back. Kachopa nicked Mullaney to Chris Reid on 22. The home side also weren't helped by an injury to Luke Wright after his record-breaking T20 exploits on Friday night. It was left instead to Joyce to play the big shots now. He hit that 6, but then mistimed another big hit off Patel to haul out to Taylor after making 59 off 69 balls. With 21 overs to go, Sussex had got to 140 for 3, but then they lost Nash, who gave Mullaney his second wicket, driving to Franklin in the covers. With 20 to go, the home side required 173 to win, but they kept on losing wickets at just the wrong time. After Machin had cleared the rope off Patel, he lost Ben Brown at the other end as Mullaney kept up the pressure with a third success. Hales, the catcher, at deep mid-wicket. Machin continued to go after Patel, another with a point to prove in this competition. The 200 was reached in the 40th over, leaving Sussex another 112 to get off the last 10. But Mullaney was a constant thorn in their side, and he ended with the fine figures of 4 for 33 from 9 overs. His final wicket, the one of Machin, who found Patel on the deep extra boundary to go for 43. That was just about it as far as the Sharks were concerned, but Pilot played an excellent hand in a losing cause. He struck Shazad for 4 fours in one over. He followed up his fine bowling with a maiden one-day 50, which came off 41 balls. It was reached in style too as he clubbed ball over mid-wicket for a 6 to go with his 6 other fours. Beer made 23 but was out towards the end of the run chase, ball removing his off stump. And in the last over, from which Sussex needed 34 runs to win, Chris Liddell was also bowled by Ball, who delivered a perfect yorker, as Sussex ended on 283 for 8. That meant a loss by 29 runs in what was a high-scoring game in front of a good crowd in Horsham. Nottinghamshire will be thrilled with their start ahead of a game at home to Somerset, who they thrashed in last year's 40-over semi-final. That's on Tuesday, while Sussex next head to Birmingham on the same day to take on Warwickshire.